I just bought this new Ferrari, but you know what I like more than cars? It's subscribing. Subscribe to this channel and you will finally be happy.
Hello there and welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman. I'm a game developer and today we're going to create a character that runs and dashes, and he's also going to be able to break stuff. So let me show you the demo. Here's the demo. I'm running Windows 10. Here's my character. He walks very slow, but if I press shift he can run faster. Now if I run through that wall, nothing happens. I'm going to run and dash. And you can see that that works not too bad. Run, dash. Alright, so let's get started. So let's open the example file, which you can find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is a link down below where you can download the free version. There is also a link to the paid version, which allows you to create commercial games. You know, games you can sell. You can see that this is just a background, just a picture, another background. I'm going to double click on my character. He has a running animation or walking animation. And this is his stop animation. Here's the wall object. Here's another active object. Here's the disappearing animation. Not very fancy. Now, if you make this visible at start, you can see that that's what we're using for the collisions. And I have a counter. Okay, so let's go to the event editor. And you can see that I have set up a basic platform controller. It's about 11 lines. Under line 12, let's create a new condition. Under the keyboard and mouse, repeat while key is being pressed. Control. Repeat while control is being pressed. Platform object, variables. Let's set the maximum velocity for the X to say 500. Copy that line, paste it, and if control is not being pressed, negate it. The maximum velocity to say somewhere around C to 170. Throw it out, press right, and hold control. And you can see that he runs faster. And if I let go of the control key, he slows down. Now you can see that the deacceleration is really rough. Notice that we have a counter here. I'm going to place this here. And if you went to the counter properties, now the maximum value of the counter is 20 and the minimum value is 2. On the line 3, we're going to set the deacceleration equals the counter. Just the X deacceleration equals this counter. Try it out. Right now the counter is set to 0, so he's not going to stop. Set the initial value of this to 2. Notice that he stops eventually. So the higher this number, the faster he's going to stop after you let go the keys. So let's make a new condition. Let's use a timer. Every 4 milliseconds, we're going to add 1 to the counter. Try it out. You can see that our character stops very fast now. So while control is being pressed, we want to subtract 1 from the counter. Try it out. And you can see that our character stops gradually now. Except for when we let go the keys and we keep holding control, he slides like that. So let's do an insert on line 12. This is only going to work if the user is pressing the right key. Let's try it out. You can see that that works not too bad. But now it doesn't work for the left. Let's do an OR. And I'm going to copy this, paste it under the OR, paste it right as well, in the same order. And we have to switch this to left. Try it out. Now for the left, and you can see that it works for both. Continue to press control, he slides a little bit, and that's what we want. Line 15, object standing on the ground, object states. Let's do an insert. This counter needs to be less than 15. Lower than 15. Repeat while pressed. The down key, not the donkey. The down key. Let's switch the animation sequence to dash. Try it out. Press control. And you can see that it works not too bad. Try it again. Run. Dash. Let's do another insert. This is only going to work. I'm going to do another insert. Keyboard and mouse. Repeat while press. Control. Try it out. So now we have to hold control for it to work. Let's do line 16. If the counter is equal to 20. Let's do an insert. Object needs to be on the ground. Another insert. And this needs to run only once when this event loops. Then we'll switch the animation back to stop. Try it out. That works fine. Let me show you these bricks. They're actually pinball objects. Those are just regular static objects. I'm going to make this visible. And under line 17, let's do a collision. This object with this wall. Let's do an insert. That's for obstacle overlap. This goes first. In that case, our character is overlapping an object. You can see that the collision works fine. Line 18. Collision between our character and the brick wall. And animation dash is playing. Dash. Then we destroy the wall. Let's try it out. You can see that that works not too bad. Now we just need some flying debris. The same line, we are going to create this bricks in front of his feet. That works fine. We just need to create more. Make this invisible. Got this counter out of the way. I'm going to double click on this action and I'm going to copy this. Change the location for each one of them. Right out. Let's make one final adjustment under the brick. Let's set the speed to random range. Try 100. As you can see, this is extremely simple. There is nothing to it. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to check out my other channel, the Sparckman Vlog. Like this video, subscribe to the channel, follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next episode.